You're watching the KPHE Penguin News Now with your host Lila
and Grant. Today is Thursday, January 17, 2019. It is our 83rd day of school. This means we have 97 days left to go in our school year after today.
Fifth grade Solar Car Club meets today in Mrs. Rush's room during afternoon recess.
Read to Feed is continuing. We hope you are reading and writing down all your minutes to earn those bracelets. Remember, you can also earn points by bringing in non-perishable food items or money.
There will be no school on Monday in honor of Martin Luther King Jr.'s birthday.
We'd like to wish Andrew in room 10 and Austin in room 22 a very
happy birthday.
We'd like to take a minute to show you some of the great things happening in fourth grade right now.
Hi, my name is Charlotte and I am in Mrs. Meter's class. And this is my passion project, which is where you have a question and you answer it. I did not find my answer, but my question was, who or what created the earth? And I interviewed a lot of people, as you can see here, and I will just tell you a little bit about the Big Bang. And a physicist sometimes likens space and time to a soup of virtual particles continually popping out of existence and theorize that a random function in this quantum foam triggered the Big Bang. What happened at the precise instant things got started is still a bit hazy, but we know what came next. The baby universe expanded rapidly, cooling as it did. 1 second after the Big Bang, the temperature had fallen about a trillion degrees Fahrenheit, and protons and neutrons appeared on the scene. Then came several minutes of nucleosynthesis, when these subatomic particles fused to form the nuclear of the mostly hydrogen and helium. And I believe that God created Earth and the solar system. And these are what other people think, as I already said. And here is a few questions. Question number one, how many days did it take God to create the Earth? And the answer is, it took 7 days in the Holy Bible. It took 6 days in another religion that I don't really know what it was called, though. And question number two, what is one theory about who or what created the Earth? And one theory is that God created the Big Bang and told it to create the Earth. And question number three, who or what do you think created the Earth? And
awesome, thanks.
Hi, my name is Nikhil, and I'm in Mrs. Meaner's class, and this is my disaster project. So we had a study on one disaster that happened in the history of the United States or in the world, and mine is earthquakes. And first I researched on how earthquakes happen and what damage it causes. And the damage it causes is that volcanoes might burst because the tectonic plates might move and the volcanoes might burst. And then we have to type it on our Chromebooks for a project, and then we have to draw a title page, and this is my title page, and yeah, that's it.
Hi, my name is Rose. I'm from room 18, and in reading, we've been doing small groups and talking about the main idea, key details, and we've been summarizing. In STEM, we've been investigating science experiments, and our most recent one was an ivory soap experiment. In social studies, we've been learning about the coastal and plateau Native Americans of Washington And we've also been learning about explorers of Washington. In math, we've been using ratio tables and doing aerial model multiplication. In writing, we're writing a realistic fiction narrative. And Passion Project is on Friday when we research our own questions and then we present to the class.
Hi, I'm Sonica and I'm in Mrs. Bargy's class. We've been learning about civil rights and studying about the civil rights movement.
Hi, my name is Brody Kohler and we've been learning about how to divide and multiply. And we've also been learning about how to figure out patterns and ways on number corner.
Hi, my name is Polly and I'm in room 21.
Hi, my name is Jake and I'm in room 21.
And we are reading these three tall tales, which is Why the Sea is Salty, John Henry, and Pickles Bill. Essential questions are, how do readers identify the seams in the literary text? How do writers use dialogue and description to develop the theme of a story?
We are learning about language and vocabulary. You see specific vocabulary, exaggeration, humorous ideas, themes clear, present through words, using translational words, paragraphs, looking words, smile.
Our focus and development. Our focus is your tale is clearly written to fully introduce the narrator and characters in the simple plot. And our development is you correctly use dialogue at least three times in your tall tale. And also colorful adjectives were used to develop characters, character traits, and the events.
Nice job, guys. Say goodbye.
Bye.
Looks like there's a lot of great learning going on.
Are you ready for this week's brain teaser? It lives in winter, dies in summer, and grows with its roots on top. What is it?
And the answer is an icicle.
That was a tricky one. Please remember to say the Pledge of Allegiance sometime today.
Let's all show our penguin pride by being safe, respectful, and responsible. This is Grant.
And Lila, saying goodbye from the Penguin News Studio.
Have a thoughtful Thursday.